Look into my eyes, tell me what you see. Can you feel my pain? I wanna sleep, not your enemy. So I just wake up and I'm like really at it, and the first thing I gotta do today is to take out the
there you go, you got it, garbage. And these little ones are just here laying down. Matter of fact, they're one of the things that I gotta do today. I gotta take her to the vet for her checkup, for her checkup and also to get shots. This one doesn't like to eat as much. She likes to eat like hype life. Like I got some lobster shells the other day and she like messed them up because she likes, you know, cooked food and stuff with your hype self. You're so fancy, huh? Stop, skate out. But her, look how big she is. Is it big? Stop, skate out. But she's on a different line. So she's definitely going to be bigger. She's what they call working class Rottweiler. So she's bigger. I got her at like 16 pounds. About 16 pounds, and I guarantee you she's somewhere around like 25 at the moment. Isn't it so? Yeah, she's going to the vet too. So the two females are going to the vet. The last time I took her, because I don't know, when I bought them from Luxury Kennels, like they didn't come with like the card or whatever. So the card is a shot card that shows all the information and stuff. So when I went with her, they were like, yo, you know, them don't want to give her a shot. I'm gonna put her up on vitamins first and blah, 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 blah. So I'm taking her back today where she can get her shots on here. Yeah. Ah. Guys, it's such a beautiful day. I brought my neighbors picking up the newspaper for them. They're out of town, so I'm just taking it up for them like a good neighbor. Well, they asked. They always call me, you know. Actually, for me, they're an older couple that I just really love. Like, it's one of those couples that, yo, I used to watch them, like when I was on my roof and I was, you know, doing some bees, like I would see like him leaving. He'd be like leaving the house, he'd drive with his car, and then he would park and literally wait and look for him girl, for his wife to go back inside, lock the gate, just to make sure that she was in. And I was just like, yo, that for me was like, yo, Jano, I can't even explain it. It's just so nice to see that kind of love. And even like when I'm over there, because like on holidays they would call me and say, oh, you guys want to come over, have a few beers? And I would come over and like they would always have stories of traveling together, and he probably couldn't remember the dates, but she remembered every single date down to the year, the month and the day. It's so beautiful. Yo, just like today. Yo, pretty today. Jesus. Jamaica, where you going, sir? Anyway, I'm gonna lock this back real quick. So I'm there back over my yard, and there's something I want to send the vlog. But first of all, I get, you guys remember to send in the Q&A's. We're definitely doing a Q&A, Judah and I. So if you have any questions, send them in. Some person were like, yo, they've been waiting for a Q&A. You know, you can send it in on my Snapchat or my Instagram. This is the last time I'm gonna say it. You know, hopefully we can get at least two questions. Please just send in some questions. Even if you want to send in two questions, then feel free, because I don't even know if people are gonna be sending questions, bro. Like, big man thing. But one thing I want to say on my vlog is, Jano, the dog need to put on back some weight. Now, I mean, I got some comments sometimes, and people are like, yo, talking about vlogging or whatever the case might be. And big man thing, there's a lot of things that you have to take into fact first, which is it's not as easy as people think. Now, the first thing is, like, for me right now, I have so many things in my life that's going on, and me can't take up nothing else. I have the dogs, see how I get to health? You're difficult, girl, it even know you're difficult. But yeah, I have the dogs I'm for deal with, which is not hard, but because they're puppies at the moment, see, and come for love and affection sometimes. But because they're puppies at the moment, everything is critical for me. So you have a disease called Prader-Willi disease. When they're this young and their bodies are this small, it killed them, and parvo disease is just in the air. You understand? That's why the dogs have to get shots and whatever. I had a Pomeranian Shih Tzu last year who died on me in the summer, and dog ball, like crazy, because me did develop more connection to this dog because the dog was living inside the house. You understand? So I have them to take care of, and that is another stress. You understand? Because them small, when they get bigger, it's not much of a problem. What else? I have work for David, I have beekeeping for David, and of course I have vlogging. Now most persons are like, yo, them want to do vlogging or whatever, but it takes a lot of time and dedication, and that comes back to, you know, me not having enough time to not even not eat right. And this is something else that I go have to put into my regimen. And I say it on the one of them just vomit. You just vomit?
Alright, where are you throwing up? You see what I'm talking about?
It goes back to exactly what I said. Right now, be kind of really worried about her because she's really, really small. Well, not so really, really small, but I'm gonna care a little bit them out. Let me know what I'm going. But anyway, yeah, so I'm up the vlogging thing for David and whatever. So this one will come for affection too. This is what I have to deal with. This is a good thing though. This is a good part. So people have to worry about vlogging and whatever, and the time is not there. So if you decide to go to the vlogging, you have to dedicate yourself. And guys, I put my word out there, so I'm gonna start the gym thing. I'm not going to become this bulky hero, but I'm saying it on the vlog because I realize when I say something on the vlog, generally, like, I just feel like I have to do it. I have to show and I have to represent. But now I just talk and I do it. Please, Jesus, give me the whey protein and Alaska so I can actually go to the gym. So that's the pre now. That's the last thing I'm gonna put on my agenda to do. Go to the gym, keep fit and whatever. But anyway. Tell him to chase them dreams. Tell him them need to start blog or do whatever. Chasing the dreams. Tell him now.
Sweet you.
Sweet you know. Guys, who sleep dead like my sister? You know how long the alarm go off and I beat off in our ears? Yo, when my alarm go off, I feel like a Freddy versus Jason. I wake up seeing them. Alright guys, so right now we have the other car. So I have to be using this one. I remember the last time when Kappa peed in the other car trunk, but this one have cloth, so I'm making preparation. So I'm gonna put garbage bag on the bottom, so if any pee get through or any dude or whatever get through, it's not gonna get through all the way. And then of course, trust the old newspaper, which I got from my neighbors, like, because they read newspapers really a lot. So there's always them giving a whole shitload, no pun intended. So this is gonna be my dilemma. With this car here, the seating is very low, so the dogs can easily get up to here. And I really don't want none of them try to come over and try to help me drive. Alright guys, so I got enough newspaper on that. FYI, whenever you're carrying your dogs, never put your dog in the trunk. Technically this is a trunk, but for this kind of car it's not like a closed trunk because it's still in the cabin of the car, so it's perfectly fine. The next thing is that when you're puppies, when you carry them to the vet, you never put the dogs on the floor, because they will pick up other diseases and whatever from the older dogs or other puppies. At the moment I can't really afford to buy one of the the dog cages, because if I was gonna buy one, I can't buy the puppy set. I have to buy like the big one. So whenever I get big, then of course I can carry one and two, whatever. But we're not gonna buy none right now, so I'm gonna go lift them up and carry them inside of the vet office or whatever. One of them big, you know, if let me lift weights. You got a hiccup, right? Guys, to show you how much we're out of time, we don't have enough time. Like right now, literally have my last pants. Not even shorts, my last pants. My laundry, don't do nothing. Like I finally got someone to come in, but she used to come in and help me out, you know, help to clean the house and whatever the case might be. But you know, she thought that we weren't here anymore or some crap like that. So you know, I got her to come back. Now she can help me clean the house, you know, at least once a month or so, and then She's coming back like probably like week after next. For kind of help me, especially like me ironing her clothes, you know, my work shirt them, and like a laundry and stuff. Because really and truly, when I tell people I'm busy, you wouldn't even understand. Like, I have vlogs right now for edit. I mean, I make vlogs. It's just like, channel. Oh, what? The vlogs I'm going to put in because we don't know where to build a team.
Are you team Marga?
For those of you who watch my House Libby channel, like my shake making is real. Like I was like in the video I told you guys that I make shakes and I put it in my fridge and I have a shake like every morning, especially when I can't, like right now I'm busy, I can't really stop and go eat breakfast and stuff. So that's what I do. Especially when I want to put on back weight and like start go to the gym. So I make like my little protein shakes and stuff. And yeah, me can see the milk mustache in the business. You know, I'm really late. We are just done brushing teeth. I got dirty teeth up again. Here comes the hard part. Mm-mm. Here we go.
Tried, almost came close.
You like that song, baby? Yeah.
You guys did really well. Like, they didn't even jump up or nothing and just ease themselves and stuff. Here comes the hard part. That's a really hard part, guys, walking with these puppies. But this is where we are. JSPCA. I think. Is it? You know what breed? No? Oh my god, look at that dog. Jeez, man. Oh gosh.
Are you a weenie?
Okay, no.
Yeah, I'm different on his body. Even if it's bigger than
me. Wow.
110 pounds, you know.
110 pounds?
Mm-hmm. Same for them.
Jeez.
Well, that makes me German shepherd.
Yeah, but you get some good breeding.
You know what? Something like that. Oh.
And he's German. Damn. First time at the vet? Well, she remember she did come last time and she never she never ready yet. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she was supposed to come last week Friday for the shaft.
Yeah.
Couldn't come, but she's here now.
Yes.
This one, fair shot based on the vaccine paper, I'm missing. But she didn't really eat a lot.
Alright guys, as always, I really like video in this space.
latte is really good. But they're saying that even though latte is really small, she's perfectly fine. She's not malnourished or anything. It's just that she's more different line as we suspected. Hopefully we'll be, I don't know. So she's gonna get her vaccinations today. Vaccinations because she got deworm the week before last. And she's gonna get deworm and unvaccinated. So that's the positiveness. No, I talked to the vlog. Someone just came in here with a Shih Tzu just now, and they had to put on a dog. So I just saw the lady come in. Listen, hey. Keep calm. I just saw the lady come in and put on the dog. See them walk with a lifeless body. Like I remember the last when I came here with my dog Lily, the Pomeranian Shih Tzu. I remember I came here, had to leave her to get sorted out, leave her overnight and stuff. Got the car. Well, I came in the other day after that, and then brought some yogurt and whatever for her stomach. And then the next day, I remember I was working and them called me and they were like, she never make it. Brother? Not a nice feeling, that's all I can tell you. Not a nice feeling. Alright guys, that wasn't so bad. We just got a checkup and whatever. This is one thing. I bought it from the breeder and unfortunately, what we should have gotten is everybody should have gotten their immunization card. But we never get them, which we should have gotten, to be quite honest with you. So we have to start them over from scratch because whatever is on the card, we don't know. As in the vet, I say, yo, you can't really tell, say, yo, this is definitely from that dog. Because I could take this picture and say, yo, somebody else. So that is for that dog, but it's for my dog. You understand? Because, yeah, so whatever. Just for safety precautions, we're doing that starting from scratch. So they both have the immunization cards now. And, yeah. I thought it was going to be harder than it was. Big man thing, yo, big up to all I single mother them, isn't it? Because my mother was a single mother. Isn't it? She raised my mother. But mother is mother. Well, I guess she'll have to raise herself because she's taking care of herself, but whatever. She is my sister and I, and it never easy. And me have them three, four dogs, and they can't really compare dogs to children, but there are some similarities. See my ball now? They don't eat from morning still. So anyway guys, I'm gonna leave you guys right here. Yo, and as always, yo, it's a joy for now that you guys are like just following the journey. You know, you guys are definitely like a part of my family, big man thing, because we share conversations and the comments and stuff, and you know, you guys give me insight and stuff, and I can help you wherever I know a thing or two. But anyway guys, this is where I'm gonna leave you at the end of this vlog, and let me just say thank you, big up on yourself, remember these three things: love, nature, adaptation. And always guys, remember to hit that like button, share the video, subscribe, and keep the link.
All I am.